Well, the topic for the talk today, given to me by the administrators of this conference, is balance sheet of life. We are all the people sitting here dealing with balance sheets day in and day out. But those balance sheets of accounts, it all money matters. But this is something different, the balance sheet of life. Because we live in this 21st century. And the state of affairs of the 21st century man and the 21st century society, we read about it, we know about it, we have heard about it, that these are the times of fancier houses but broken homes. These are the times of double incomes and more divorces. These are the times of high-rise buildings and low-rise characters. These are the times of broader highways but narrower viewpoints. These are the times where man has gone all the way to the moon and has come back. But he finds it difficult to cross the road and meet the new neighbor. These are the times where man has broken the atom and he has produced a tremendous amount of energy. But he finds it difficult to break a prejudice. We have broken the atom, but we find it difficult to break a prejudice. The list is very long describing the state of affairs of the 21st century man and society, but in short you can say that these are the times where we have much to show in the show window and nothing in the stockroom. दिखाने के लिए हमारे पास बहुत सारी चीजें हैं, लेकिन हृदय में एक शुद्ध भावना, मन में पवित्र विचार, वो कम होते जा रहे हैं. इसलिए whenever I talk to chartered accountants, I've talked in n number of occasions of chartered accountants at WIRC, at SIRC, 2 years back in SIRC we had 3,500 chartered accountants. My very good friend, he was the chairman of SIRC, Mr. Falguna Kumar. He invited me for the talk at Tirupati. And about 7-8 years back in Mumbai, I talked to like about 2,200 chartered accountants at Yogi Sabhaguru in Dadar. So I always have a good rapport with the chartered accountants. So whenever I talk to them, I say CA is not just a chartered accountant, but CA also means a careful analyst of life. CA. CA is not just a chartered accountant. It also means a careful analyst of life. आप लोगों की कंपनीज की बैलेंस शीट बनाते हो, आपके जीवन भी की एक बैलेंस शीट बनानी चाहिए, बनाते होंगे. लेकिन आई एम गोइंग टू इन्फ्यूज सम गुड वैल्यूज इनटू इट टुडे. द फर्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ मेकिंग अ बैलेंस शीट ऑफ योर लाइफ वेरी वेल इज दैट वी हैव टू इंट्रोस्पेक्ट दैट बेसिकली वी आर द ओनली एग्जिस्टेंस अपॉन दिस अर्थ दैट वी हैव बीन गिफ्टेड विद द पावर टू थिंक बाय गॉड. नो अदर एनिमल हैज दिस. We have been gifted with the power to collect information, the power to transform that information into knowledge, and ultimately process that knowledge into wisdom. But the miserable state of affairs is that very less percentage of this information has been transformed into knowledge, and perhaps very, very less, 0.00001% perhaps of that knowledge has been transformed into wisdom. And so we are not able to make a good balance sheet of life because we have not processed that information into knowledge and knowledge into wisdom. Your job as professionals is to make balance sheet of companies and individuals. Our job as saints is to make you understand better the balance sheet of life. So we are all into the same profession, making balance sheets. But we are into a different sphere. So we need to introspect, why am I a specially privileged entity upon this earth who has this power? And to utilize that power judiciously makes us a complete human being, gives us a balance sheet of life. Because perhaps in this 21st century, very sad to say, but the real story is this: literate people have caused more damage to the society than illiterate people. See, these bombs and missiles are not made by illiterate people. I'm now justifying my statement. These bombs and missiles and weapons of mass destruction are not made by illiterate people. They are made by some of the best science graduates from some of the best universities. Okay, again, thefts and crimes performed by illiterate people are small. If they commit a theft, it is 5,000 rupees, 50,000 rupees. And if a literate person deciding to do and go for it, and in power perhaps, he can do 1 lakh crores, 1.5 lakh crores, 2 lakh crores. So literate people have caused more damage to this society than illiterate people. And sometimes in the worst unethical practices that a profession goes into, he can maneuver the balance sheets of companies, and that is also causing a big damage to society, the government, and the nation. If somebody goes, majority of you don't go, but if somebody in your profession goes, he can maneuver things, maneuver balance sheets. And for the small petty profit or benefit of this company, he can create a huge loss to the society, the exchequer. So today, the literate people, they cause more damage to the society than illiterate people, just because of one reason: that they lack in the basic ethical values, the sanskars of life. That is the principal reason that would arrange, adjust your balance sheet of life well. We need to focus on that. Too much of leaning towards materialism and lesser importance towards morality and spirituality is one of the principal reasons where our balance sheets are not gaining equality at the end. But remember one thing: too much leaning towards materialism in life has got severe repercussions and could damage our life physically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. You should always have a balance of materialism and spirituality in life. That would balance your sheet well. Because if there are 100 things that money can buy and make you happy, there are other 1,000 things that money cannot buy, and you still need them to be more happy in life. After this seminar, you go back home and make a good balance sheet. The left column is things that money can buy: a flat, a bungalow, a car, a farmhouse, an office, all the things that money can buy and make you happy. And on the other side of the balance sheet, you write down things that money cannot buy: trust, friendship, relationships, truth, health, that money cannot buy, and you want it to be more happy. You will find, as a chartered accountant, that the left-hand side column stands no position in front of the right-hand side column, that things that money cannot buy and you are happy. You have to give a thought once in a while to it and lean to have a proper balance of materialism and spirituality in life. We always feel that more money, more happiness, more luxuries, more happiness, which is a wrong notion and the biggest disease of the 21st century professional. So they are not able to make their life a balanced one. I sometimes jokingly say that we feel that for me, heaven upon earth and me, hell upon this earth is a very simple definition. Me means we all. That if I get a combination of these 5 things in life, it is heaven on earth. And if I get the combination of the other 5 things, it's hell upon earth. The combination of 5 things that we feel that can make heaven for me upon this earth is this 5 things: American salary, if you are paid in dollars, a British house, a German car, an Audi or a Merc, Skoda or a Rolls, Chinese food, four things, American salary, British house, German car, Chinese food, and Indian wife. This five combination, if I get in my life, it's heaven on earth. And you know the reverse of it, the hell on earth? Indian salary. They say Chinese house because sometimes people live in boat houses there. They don't have enough space to live. So they live in boat houses. They say German food. They say American car. So four things. Indian salary, Chinese house, German food, American car, and a British wife. Because they say three W's, they change in Britain anytime. Weather, wine, and wife. They change in Britain anytime. And perhaps that could perhaps be the reason, I don't know, that at the start of every website, they have www. At the start of every website, they have www. Maybe because of this reason that you can open up and get anything from it. Just lighter moments apart, what I mean to say is you need a balance of materialism and spirituality to make a balance sheet of your life. Otherwise, you will repent at the end of your life if you have not balanced it well. Napoleon Bonaparte said, I can buy any riches upon this earth and under the sun. I can have the world at my feet, but I haven't seen six happy days in my life. Elvis Presley, the king of rock and roll, his limousine cars were studded with diamonds. And the cavalcade of seven limousine cars. When the president of America did not have it, he had it. And he was the first superstar, perhaps the greatest entertainer the planet has ever seen, traveling by private jets. First jet would take him and his team, and the second jet his audio system at the stage. When he was just 21, there were more than 30 Elvis endorsed products in the market. And his biographer, he writes that Elvis is only the second person in history to become famous by the first name after Jesus. That popularity. Self-earned $1,000 million in 1975. By the year 1975, when he was just 32, self-earned $1,000 million. The king of rock and roll. Today at his memorial in Memphis, every day from all over the world, about more than 1,000 people visit. At the age of 33, when once his secretary, she stepped in, he was playing his famous composition, How Great Thou Art, on his piano. And his secretary asked, sir, how are you feeling at the peak of your career? And he dropped his hand from the piano and said, alone. Are bhai sahab, every day in the evening you get an audience from 1,000 to 5,000 people wanting to see you. And you, after doing your famous swivel, he would open up his leather jacket and throw in the audience. And within seconds it would be small pieces. People would take a Elvis souvenir back home. That fame, and you say you're feeling alone? And on 16th August 1977, at the age of 33, Elvis took 40 sleeping pills at night and never woke up. He committed suicide. At the age of 33, at the peak of his career. Absolute and overwhelming desire for materialism in life and overleaning towards it will land you nowhere. You need to have a balance of materialism and morality and spirituality in life. Otherwise, we can be a good loser, made Napoleon Bonaparte or Elvis Presley. I have hundreds of these examples. So when I talk to professionals, I come from one of the largest organizations in the world, the BAPS Swaminarayan Sanstha. We are among the top 10 NGOs of the world, with a permanent seat in the United Nations as an NGO. We do 162 different kinds of activities all over the world. How many of you have been to Akshardham at Ahmedabad or Delhi? Just raise your hands. like most of you. Such 1,200 campuses we have in 60 countries of the world. We have more than 100 hospitals, hostels, schools and colleges. And everything of this, this 1,200 campuses and 1,000 social institutes created by one person, Pramukh Swami Maharaj, single-handedly and successfully administered it. आपके पास तो एक ऑफिस, एक सेटअप, एक घर होगा तो भी शाम को 5 बजे तक तो पागल हो जाते होंगे. तो सच 1,200 कैंपसेस ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड ही सिंगल हैंडेडली इरेक्टेड दोज एंड सक्सेसफुली एडमिनिस्टर्ड इट. ही इनिशिएटेड मोर देन 1,200 सेंट्स लाइक अस. Out of them, more than 750 of our saints are graduates, postgraduates, chartered accountants, doctors, and engineers. And nice to tell you today that more than 8 saints of the organization, they are chartered accountants, CAs. Out of them, 2 are from Africa and 1 is from the US. I think they call it the CPA there, something. Yeah, and 1 is from London. Out of those, about 150 saints are born American and British citizens. Out of those, about more than 50 saints in the organization, they are Cambridge, Oxford, Stanford, Yale, Carnegie Mellon graduates. So standing in front of you today, trying to give you some insight into balance sheet of life is not just a couple of books read, I'm coming in front of you. We are deeply involved in the administration and the management of this organization, so we know what is administration, what is no management, we know what is HR, we know what is networking, we know what is infrastructure and system. We are 8 hours into it. What I'm talking to you now is my part-time job. It's not my full-time job. It's my hobby. To share and care for the society. And I've been talking since 24 years. I've not charged a single penny to anybody for my talks, not even today. It's just my selfless service to society. Why I'm telling you this is US professionals have one side experience of professionalism and work. We have two side experience of professionalism, work and spirituality. So I can talk to you about it from the balance point of view. Pramukh Swami Maharaj, you created this organization to this level. And I tell you, it's easy to run a corporate, difficult to run an NGO of this class, because in your corporate work structure you have pay and smile relationship with the between the employer and the employee. The employee likes the pay of the employer, so there is a smile on his face, and the employer likes the work of the employee, so there is a smile on his face. It's called pay and smile relationship. You are in NGO, we have serve and smile relationship. You have to serve selflessly, lifetime, and keep a smile on your face and smile in your life. Difficult to run an NGO of this level than a corporate. Pramukh Swami Maharaj was successful in running this NGO to this level. And the amount of hard work that he put, he traveled to 18,000 villages in 60 countries in his lifetime. We have seen him at the age of 70, 75 and 80, at 12 midnight, traveling to deep Adivasi hutments, bettering the life of people. People used to write to him for their personal or family issues. He read and answered more than 7.5 lakh letters in his lifetime, at an unbelievable average of reading and answering 70 letters a day for 45 years without a Sunday. Ek vyakti kitni had tak kaam kar sakta hai, main aapko andaaz deta hu. So 8 ghante aap kaam kare office mein aur shaam ko, my God, too much tired, ye kabhi mat bolna. He met more than 2 million people personally, converse with them. He personally visited, as we have come to your occasion today, 3.5 lakh in his lifetime. He was a one-man organization, one-man army. Why I narrated this to you, that because he had the balance of work and spirituality in life, he was always at peace with himself and peace in the surrounding. Balance of materialism and spirituality. When he was asked which thought remains with you 24/7, he said, the thought that has never entered my mind, shall I tell it first? And that was more interesting. And he said, the thought of hurting anybody physically, mentally or emotionally has never entered my mind. किसी का अहित हो मेरे जीवन में कभी वो विचार नहीं आया. This is spirituality. आप तो जानने की कोशिश करते हो कि मेरे जो कॉम्पिटिटर है उसके पास क्लाइंट्स कितने हैं, कौन कौन क्लाइंट्स उसके पास जाते हैं, और वो जो क्लाइंट है उसके पास तो पहुंचने के लिए मेरे पास एक मिडल मैन है. आई कैन टेल हिम दैट यू कैन कम टू मी नॉट टू हिम. थोड़ी अंतर्दृष्टि करना. उसके हिसाब से, उसके नसीब से, उसकी पढ़ाई से, उसके काम से वो कुछ कमा रहा है. ही इज लिविंग हिज लाइफ by your education, your know-how, your experience, your dignity, you work and you earn. Simple. One thought of spirituality can balance your life. There are hundreds of such thoughts which can balance your life well. So CA is not just a chartered accountant, he is a careful analyst of life, CA. So for balance of life, to make a good balance sheet of life at the end of your life, I take seminars with professionals and I teach them a system that I have devised out of my reading and experiences and traveling all the world and meeting professionals. Every second day I'm talking to professionals at some or the other place. I've devised a theory that 8 plus 8 plus 8 is the system for balance sheet in life. Of the 24 hours that you have in your life every day, it should be well distributed into 8 plus 8 plus 8 system. आपको प्रवचन में और कोई बातें याद ना रहे तो ये एक बात घर लेके जाना. 8 plus 8 plus 8. First 8 hours of the day, your honest, ethical hard work in your profession. First 8 hours of the day is your honest, ethical hard work in your profession. Second 8 hours is a good sleep or rest. Third 8 hours are very important. If you're not able to manage the third 8 hours of the day, you may lose your life. And if you can well manage the third 8 hours of the day, you can well win your life. The third 8 hours of the day, we teach, it is 3F, 3H, and 3S. 3F is family, friends, and faith. 3H is health, hygiene, and hobby. And 3S is your soul, service, and smile. These 9 departments should consume the third 8 hours of the day. Of course, in fragments. If you can well distribute your day into 8 plus 8 plus 8 system, it is a good balance sheet of life. A good balance sheet of day and thus your life. Again, I repeat, the third 8 hours are 3F, 3H, and 3S. 3F is family, friends, and faith. 3H is health, hygiene, hobby. 3S is soul, service, and smile. Into these 9 departments, you distribute your third 8 hours of time, and it is a balanced life, well lived. So you don't have complaints from any quarters of life, from any people in your life. Because you have lived a balanced life. You have given even enough time apart from your profession to your family, to your friends, to your faith, to your health, to your hygiene, to your hobby, to your services, any NGO or any good cause of the society that you are involved with. So well distribution of time, well balance of time, that can give you a good balance sheet of life. Varna companies ya professionals ki jo balance sheet banate ho paise ki. अपनी लाइफ की बनानी बहुत जरूरी है, अदरवाइज यू विल रिपेंट एट द एंड ऑफ योर लाइफ. मुगल सम्राट औरंगजेब बोले, सारी जिंदगानी फिजूल गई. नेपोलियन बोनापार्ट बोले, आई हैवंट सीन 6 हैप्पी डेज इन माय लाइफ. तो ये बारी आपकी न आए एट द एज ऑफ 70 और 80, इसके लिए ये बात और विचार है. एंड आई समटाइम्स jokingly say that the amount of money that is in your bank account when you die is the extra work you did, you shouldn't have done. Aapko zarurat nahi thi.
क्योंकि आपके मरने के बाद वो पैसे कहां जाएंगे, कैसे जाएंगे, किस तरह से यूज होगा, वो आपको तो पता है नहीं.
सो नाउ इन अमेरिका मिलियनर्स एंड बिलियनर्स क्लब हैज स्टार्टेड. द बेसिक क्राइटेरिया फॉर मेंबरशिप इन दिस क्लब इज दैट यू हैव टू प्लेज एंड डोनेट 80% ऑफ ऑल योर वेल्थ, ओनली देन यू बिकम द मेंबर ऑफ दिस क्लब. और उसमें थाउजेंड्स ऑफ पीपल हैं. बिकॉज द पावर ऑफ मनी इज इन गिविंग, नॉट एक्युमुलेटिंग. To understand this basics of spirituality gives you a balance sheet of life. Balance sheet of your life, अगर आपने unethical practices की तो एक दिन बिगड़ सकती है. Unethical practice करके आपने किसी की balance sheet तो सुधार दी, लेकिन आपके जीवन की balance sheet बिगड़ जाएगी. Because you have cheated with your conscience. Cheated with the exchequer, वो तो बाद की बात है. You have cheated your own conscience because with your own hands and own mind you have done something wrong. An unethical practice will land you nowhere. आपकी balance sheet बिगड़ जाएगी. Remember, no pillow is as soft as a clear conscience. आप रात को सोते वक्त सबसे अच्छा pillow कौन सा है आपके लिए? A clear conscience that I have not done anything wrong today. And if you do something wrong, you are into the animal phylum, not the human phylum. And unethical practices ki, to aapki balance sheet of life jarur bigad sakti hai. Even if the name of your company is Satyam and you go for Asatya practices, you can be in jail for 7 years. A man of 8,000 crores. Let's step up. Even if you are the Sahara of thousands of families by creating homes for them, you can still lie be Sahara in Tihar for 4 years. Hayana, a man of 20,000 crores. Even if you are the king of the skies, you have to leave India without an Indian passport, on a diplomatic passport. आएंगे जनाब थोड़े दिन में वापस भारत में. एक्सट्राडिशन की बात चल रही है, लंदन कोर्ट ने ऑलमोस्ट डिसीजन दे दिया है. एंड व्हेन ही विल कम हियर एंड ओपन हिज माउथ, लॉट मेनी पीपल कैन बी इन ट्रबल. यस और नो? सो इवन इफ यू आर राजू और राजा और किंग और एनीबडी, अनएथिकल प्रैक्टिसेस कैन लैंड यू इन जेल. अनएथिकल प्रैक्टिसेस कैन रूइन योर करियर एंड योर लाइफ. And the stress that comes in because of unethical practices, when you are caught, your balance sheet of life is spoiled permanently. You will lose your career, you will lose your practice, you will lose your life, you will lose your family. So, thoda profit mile, usse anand mein rehna, lekin ethical practices kabhi chhodna mat. That is your lifeline. Even if you are, after becoming an electrical engineer, for example, in your 30 years of practice with the Maharashtra Electricity Board, you don't have the right to put your finger inside the plug. Aap plug ke samne baith ke apni ungli dikhaoge ki I am the chairman of the Maharashtra Electricity Board, 35 years of distribution of electricity under my belt, then I am the absolute power authority. This is my finger. Ye keh ke bhi aap plug mein andar ungli daloge, electricity doesn't know your post, position and power. It only knows human flesh and blood. Chipka degi, mar jaoge. Usi tarah ethical, unethical jo practices hai, wo aapki post, position, power ko nahi pehchanti. I am a chartered accountant practicing in Mumbai since 40 years. Whoever you are. Unethical practices is like electricity. It doesn't know your post, position and power. Chipka degi, mar jaoge. Am I right or wrong? I'm asking the elders. Absolutely right. They have years of experience sitting in the front and leading from the front. And you all have experiences of this kind. Aapne baatein suni bhi hogi. Ye koi nayi baat nahi hai. To hamesha ethical practices ke liye jana, to balance sheet of life achhi maintain rahegi, wahan bigad jayegi. Delhi Akshardham mein to roz hamare 17,000 log aate hain pichle 13 saal se.
जनरल विजिटर्स बुक में सब लिख सकते हैं। एक व्यक्ति ने लिखा था कि मैं हरियाणा के एक छोटे से गांव में से आता हूं, मैं मेरा काम यह है कि मैं रोज सुबह साइकिल में दो दूध के कैन लेके घर घर जाके दूध बांटता हूं। हमारे गांव में 80-100 घर है, छोटा सा गांव, स्मॉल हैमलेट इन रूरल पार्ट ऑफ हरियाणा। लेकिन यह अक्षरधाम आया, दिल्ली तो मैं सिर्फ दो दफा आया हूँ जीवन में 50 साल की उम्र में। एक बार जो हमारे गांव में कोई बड़े घर में शादी थी तो बारात में आया था, और दूसरी दफा सबने बोला चलो अक्षरधाम देखने के लिए चलते हैं, तो अभी आया यहाँ, अक्षरधाम देखा, प्रदर्शनी सब देखी। इतनी प्रेरणाएं मिली कि आज से मैं प्रतिज्ञा लेता हूं कि मैं अपने दूध में पानी नहीं डालूंगा। एथिकल प्रैक्टिस। मुझे सिर्फ इतना कहना है कि एक दूध वाले को भी एथिकल प्रैक्टिस की प्रेरणा मिलती है तो हम सब तो पढ़े लिखे हैं, हम सब तो पढ़े लिखे हैं, तो हमको तो एथिकल प्रैक्टिसेस की प्रेरणा मिलनी ही चाहिए। हम कर रहे हैं, ज्यादातर कर रहे हैं, लेकिन कभी अनएथिकल विचार अगर आ गया तो रोक देना उसको। मनुष्य है, मन है, कभी आ जाता है, बड़ा लाभ दिखता है। किसी की बैलेंस शीट एडजस्ट करने के बाद जो कैश मिलता है ना, उसमें बहुत बड़ी बात दिखती है। तो कभी अगर मन लालायत हो गया तो रोक देना, क्योंकि वो मार्ग बहुत खतरनाक है, डेंजरस है, आपको चौपट कर सकता है। सो गो फॉर एथिकल प्रैक्टिस इज ऑलवेज द स्लो ग्रोथ बिकॉज ऑफ एथिकल प्रैक्टिस, बट इट इज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग ग्रोथ। And nothing is bigger in a professional career than credit. Yes or no? आपकी इज्जत से कोई बड़ी बात नहीं है। And remember one thing: everything lost, but credit remaining with you, everything can be regained. And everything with you and credit lost, everything is lost. Yes or no? So balance sheet of life के लिए बहुत जरूरी है। Ethics in your profession. एथिकल प्रैक्टिसेस हमेशा करना। अब बैलेंस शीट के लाइफ ये भी जरूरी है कि यू मैनेज योर 8+8+8 सिस्टम। कोक के वर्ल्ड सीईओ थे ब्रायन डायसन, उनकी एक 30 सेकंड की स्पीच है। अगर ऑर्गेनाइजर्स को एक विनंती है कि अगर अनुकूल हो तो यूट्यूब पे से डाउनलोड करके आप कोई भी सेशन में दिखाना, यहां 30 सेकंड है सिर्फ। एक बी स्कूल के कॉन्वकेशन में वे बोले थे, and a top corporate position, world CEO of Coca-Cola, Brian Dyson, after his 40 years of experience in the corporate world, he was sharing his experiences, but he just made a 30-second speech. बहुत अच्छी बात उन्होंने कही उस स्पीच में, मैं थोड़ी एलाबरेट करके आपको वो बैलेंस शीट ऑफ लाइफ कैसी है वो बताते हैं वे। उन्होंने बोला कि my 40 years of experience in the corporate field has taught me one thing, and that is get to work on time, work very effectively during your working hours, and get back to your family on time. This is balance sheet of life. Get back to your family on time. ये पहली बात उन्होंने बताई कि मेरे 40 साल का अनुभव मुझे ये सिखाया। Then he said, in life, you are actually juggling with 5 balls. हमने सर्कस में जोकर को देखा ना, he's juggling with more than 2, 3, 5 balls. In life, you are juggling with 5 balls in hand. The first ball is the ball of work. Second is the ball of family. Third is the ball of health. Fourth is the ball of friends. And fifth is the ball of spirit. You are dealing with these 5 balls in life. Then the third point, he said, that after many years of juggling with this 5 balls, you will come to know that the first ball, that is ball of work, is made up of rubber, and the rest 4 balls, that is health, family, spirit and friends, is made up of glass. The fourth thing he said, that the ball of work is made up of rubber. If you lose it and falls on the ground, it will bounce back because it is made up of rubber. That is, work opportunities will keep on coming. As the chairman of Virgin Atlantic, he says that work is like bus stand, a bus comes every 3 minutes. But Brian Dyson says the other 4 balls of your life, family, friends, health and spirit, are made up of glass. If you lose them,
they fall on the floor, it will break. If not break, crack. If not crack, it will D-shape. But it will not be the same again. It will not be the same again. So take care of your work, take care of your family, take care of your health, take care of your friends. Live a balanced life. Money is not everything in life. Not even your professional career is everything in your life. Live as a human being. Don't live as a professional. Just work as a professional, but live as a human being. That is the balance of life. क्योंकि एक गिनती मैं आपको कराऊं, आप ताज्जुब रह जाएंगे. चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स को कोई गिनती करानी हो तो हमें भी बहुत ध्यान रखना पड़ता है. आई विल गिव यू सम कैलकुलेशन टाइम. वी स्लीप फॉर 8 hours अ डे. आप बोलते होंगे मैं 6 घंटा सोता हूं, तो जब बचपन में छोटे थे तब 10 घंटा सोते थे, जब बड़े होंगे वृद्ध होंगे तभी 10 घंटा सोएंगे. द एवरेज विल कम डाउन ऑफ द होल लाइफ एज 8 hours अ डे. So of the 24 hours you sleep for 8 hours a day, that means 1/3 of the day you are sleeping. Yes or no? 24 divided by 3 is 8. Rather divided by 8 is 3. So 1/3 of the day you sleep, that is directly proportional that 1/3 of the life you will sleep. Yes? Balance sheet mein milta hai na? That means if you live for 70 years upon this earth, 1/3 of your life, 23 years of your life is going to be in bed sleeping. You don't know whether you exist or not. 23 years of your life out of 70 years is going to be in sleep. You don't know whether you exist or not. You just have a 90-second brush and more than 100 days of your life goes in brushing your teeth. Now I am not giving you the calculation of the time you spend in front of the mirror. आगे से आप अपने आप को देखते हो, पीछे से देखते हो, इस तरफ से देखते हो, अब कुछ फर्क नहीं होने वाला है. Actual time with you is very less, very less. If you are not conscious about living a balanced life, you can be a big loser in life. Warren Buffett, the richest investor upon this earth, with an investment of more than $100 billion. On his 50th marriage anniversary, the couple were sitting on the dais and 50 parties were arranged by the 63 CEOs of Berkshire Hathaway, the flagship company. And the concluding party was in London. And was attended by more than 30 heads of states of Europe and Africa and America. Very dignified crowd. And everybody was sharing their experiences with the couple. Some with the work, some with the foundation, whatever. A gentleman, he must be a chartered accountant. He raised his hand and said, if you don't mind, can I ask you a very simple question to the couple? He said, the couple said, fine. And he asked, sir, what is the secret of your happy married life of 50 years? See, he had used the adjective happy before married life, eh? What is the secret of your happy married life of 50 years? And before Warren Buffett could start answering in the microphone, his wife, she pulled over the microphone and said, I would like to answer this question. That pulling of the microphone and not a single change of wrinkle on Warren Buffett's face, 50% of the answer the people got from this act, how they would have continued for 50 years. Now listen carefully. Warren Buffett's wife, she said, in our 50 years of married life, there has not been a single day where me, my husband and our children, thereafter our grandchildren, and thereafter today our great-grandchildren, we have not sat for dinner together at 8 p.m. I'm talking of the world's richest man and the richest investor. Unless and until he is traveling out. Rest of the family, they sit together at 8. Now put a hand on your chest and ask yourself how many times in a week you sit for dinner together with your family. Then the second point she said, there has not been a single day in our 50 years of married life that me and my husband Warren Buffett, we have not gone out for a half an hour of walk in the evening after dinner. Third, she said, There has not been a single day that where me and my husband we have not sat together to tuition our children. Thereafter we tuitioned our great our grandchildren, and today we are teaching at the age of 73 our great grandchildren, teaching them numericals and alphabets. And you are sending your children and grandchildren to tuition classes or tuition centers, coming back home to teach them, just because you could afford tuition money, and Warren Buffett must not be affording, isn't it? When they were asked why, she said, "We want to transmit our family values to the next generation. They must know the tradition and the culture of this family. So we spend quality and quantity time with our family members." So this is called a balance sheet of life, well maintained. For that, when Warren Buffett was asked, he said that from 9 to 6, I am a businessman. From evening 6 to 9, I am a family man. And from 9 to 10:30, I am a personal spiritual entity. This is balance of life. He said that I shut off my mobile at 6 p.m. in the evening. He throws his pen on the table at 6 p.m. and gets up. And somebody asked, any client after that? He said, I tell them, you can come tomorrow at 10. My office hours are 9 to 6. And you keep your mobile phones on till 11 p.m. and 12 midnight. Till the last time you go on the bed, and still after getting on the bed, you check. Are you expecting a call from the PM's office? That because I'm a chartered accountant, I know much about 2G, 3G, coal scam, maybe a bit about Rafael Adil. And so sometimes if a JPC is formed, Joint Parliamentary Committee, and the Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi would call me, that being a chartered accountant, you know so much of these things, I want you to be on the JPC. Are you expecting a call? Aapko wo jante bhi nahi hai. आप चेक करना रात को 8-9 बजे के बाद जो मैसेजेस आते हैं उसमें कोई इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है, वो सब कचरा ही है. इट्स ऑल गार्बेज. द बिगेस्ट गार्बेज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इज व्हाट्सएप. गार्बेज आते रहते हैं. व्हाई आर यू पुटिंग योर माइंड इनटू इट, इग्नोरिंग योर फैमिली. After 7 p.m., your family has absolute right on your time. Am I right or wrong? ये मत सोचना कि पैसे कमाते मैं family को luxury देता हूँ बस, that is my responsibility. No, time giving is the biggest responsibility. अभी Harvard University में एक सर्वे हुआ. What is the greatest joy upon this earth? 110 countries surveyed, more than 1 lakh families across caste, creed, color, region, nationality surveyed over a period of 8 years. And the principal question was, what according to you is the biggest joy upon this earth? You would be surprised that 67% of the respondents, they said that spending quality and quantity time with your near and dear ones whom you love and who love you is the greatest joy upon this earth. Include this joy of family time in your balance sheet, and it is a well-maintained balance sheet. आप रात को 9 बजे 11 बजे घर पहुंचते हो, एक्सक्लूड 8 हॉलीडे वीकेंड्स ऑफ द मंथ, दैट इज 8 डेज अपार्ट फ्रॉम 30, दैट कम्स टू 22. अनदर 4 डेज इफ यू गो बैक होम आफ्टर 9 p.m., फाइन, यू हैड सम वर्क इन इमरजेंसी. अनदर 4 डेज यू गो आफ्टर 8, इट्स फाइन, इट वॉज ट्रैफिक, सम वर्क. रेस्ट 16 टू 18 डेज यू शुड बी बाय 6:30 और मैक्सिमम 7 विथ योर फैमिली. देन यू only then you can be labeled as you are a good manager of work and time. Otherwise roz aapko raat 9:30 10 baj jate hai ghar jane mein, to let me tell you frankly on your face that you are a very very poor manager of time and money. Balance rakhte hain. Kumar Mangalam Birla ka interview of Times of India mein padhna, mere paas wo cutting hai. Kumar Mangalam Birla, the chairman of the Aditya Birla Group, a 5 lakh crore conglomerate from salt to software. He and his wife were interviewed by the Times of India on some occasion, and they were asked, how do you manage your time between your office, work, travel time, meetings, social time? You live in the town in South Mumbai, so you must be having at least 5 invitations every day. They said, yes. How are you managing it? Kumar Mangalam's wife, she said, Now listen very carefully. She said, now I'm quoting her not just word to word but letter to letter. She said that there is a custom in the Birla house that everybody has to deposit their mobile phone with the mother at 8 p.m. Even Kumar Mangalam Birla has to.
ये कक्षा के परिवार जीवन समझते हैं, ये कक्षा के बिजनेसमैन वो बैलेंस रखते हैं जीवन में.
एंड द इंटरव्यूअर वाज शॉक्ड, सर देन व्हाट डू यू डू आफ्टर 8 पीएम, एज इफ लाइफ डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट विदाउट अ मोबाइल.
दिस गैजेट इज मेड टू सर्व यू एंड वी हैव बिकम द स्लेव्स ऑफ इट. कॉन्शियसली और अनकॉन्शियसली इफ आवर हैंड डजंट टच द मोबाइल फोन एवरी थर्ड मिनट इन द पॉकेट वी गेट डिस्चार्ज्ड.
And what do you do after that? The interviewer asked, and she said that at 8 p.m. everybody sits for dinner. It's a 45-minute dinner time. After 8:45 to 9:30, we just are there chatting, talking of the day's happenings, or the history of the family, or some planning of the coming occasion, event. Then at 9:30, the mother, that is Aditya Birla's widow, Kumar Mangalam's mother, she gives from her pouch the mobile phone back to every individual. Even Kumar Mangalam has to get it. Huh? And then it is given to us for only 10 minutes to check urgencies or emergencies. Then we have to place our mobile back on the table. Then we are into our hobbies. Somebody may read a book or somebody may watch a TV program or something like that. Somebody may chat with a friend, whatever. तो ऐसे परिवारों में भी बैलेंस ऑफ लाइफ है. इफ वॉरेन बफेट कैन डू इट, इफ कुमार मंगलम बिरला कैन डू इट, इफ यू डिसाइड कैन यू गिव मी अ स्ट्रॉन्गर वन, यू कैन बिकॉज यू आर चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स, यू नो व्हाट इज बैलेंस. मेक अप गुड बैलेंस शीट ऑफ योर लाइफ. ये समझना मैं एक संत के रूप में सिर्फ बात नहीं कर रहा हूं, हम भी 8-10 घंटा काम करते हैं. We run hospitals, hostels, schools and colleges. We run 162 different kinds of activities. जो दिल्ली में अक्षरधाम है वहां हमारा स्टाफ 800 का है. शायद आप में से एक भी यहां नहीं बैठे हो जिनका स्टाफ 800 का होगा. 800. And they are full from HR to administration to management to infrastructure to system. सब हम संत करते हैं. तो we know all these things. ये दो बात सीख के कोई अच्छी सलाह देने के लिए आपके पास नहीं आया हूं. हम बैलेंस करते हैं, आप भी बैलेंस कर सकते हो तो ही आपको जीवन में संतोष मिलेगा. ये बैलेंस अगर नहीं कर पाए तो पूरा दिन दौड़ 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 किया. डू यू वॉन्ट टू ड्रिंक द होल सी ऑफ योर प्रोफेशन? टेल मी यस और नो. यहां पुणे से कितने आए? जस्ट रेज योर हैंड्स. मुझे बताया गया कहीं आए, कहीं आए. मुंबई से कितने आए? आए. मैं आपको ये प्रश्न पूछना चाहता हूं कि आप पुणे में प्रैक्टिस करते हो चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट के रूप में. पुणे में जितनी कंपनीज हैं और जितना अकाउंटिंग का काम है वो सब आपके पास आपके टेबल पे आपके फर्म में आ गया तो कर पाओगे कि नहीं? ऑल द वर्क यू आर फ्रॉम पुणे, एवरी एंड ऑल द अकाउंटिंग वर्क of the entire city of Pune comes on your table, then mar jaoge na, sanyas le lunga, aa jao is taraf. Kyunki wahan jo karte ho usko kaam bolte hain, yahan jo karte ho usko seva bolte hain. Bahut fark hai. Wahan stress aayega, yahan karte hue bhi stress nahi aayega. In the last one week I traveled to six cities: Aurangabad, Nasik, Delhi, अकोला, नागपुर, टुडे सहगांव, टुमोरो आई विल टॉक इन मुंबई. स्ट्रेस नहीं है. देखो काम तो हम भी करते हैं, बैलेंस मेंटेन करना पड़ेगा स्पिरिचुअलिटी के साथ. व्हाट आई मीन टू से, यू कैन व्हेनेवर यू आर अटमोस्ट थर्स्टी यू कैन हैव मैक्सिमम 2 glasses ऑफ वाटर और अ जग ऑफ वाटर. यू कैन नेवर ड्रिंक द होल प्रोफेशन, होल सी ऑफ योर प्रोफेशन, इजंट इट? देन व्हाई आर यू सिटिंग टिल 11 पीएम इन योर ऑफिस? स्ट्रेस बढ़ेगा, चिंता बढ़ेगी, अनएथिकल प्रैक्टिसेस की तरह लीनिंग बढ़ेगा काम की बोझ की वजह से.
People have understood this. So the France government has passed a bill from the parliament. It has become a constitutional law in France. And the law is the right to reject work after 6 p.m. If you are a French citizen and working in France, you have the right to reject work at 6 p.m. Aapke boss ka mail aap pe aaya, and if the mail is at 6.01 minute, you have the right to reject it. Ye bhi nahi answer dena ki kal 9 baje aapko mail karunga. Nothing, you don't touch it. It is a constitutional right. Aur isse bhi badi baat aapko kahun. Next week they will pass a bill in the parliament in New Zealand. 4-day week. It is the first experiment upon this earth. But for last 1.5 years, they have surveyed all professions in the country of New Zealand. They have come to this decision after consultations with high-end professionals, middle-end professionals, and low-end professionals in all professions. And they have come to this conclusion, 4-day week, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday. We jante hain balance sheet of life maintain karni padegi. I was talking at IIM Udaipur just about 2 weeks back to the fresh students there who have joined the management program. I was supposed to talk on IQ, EQ, SQ, and thereafter we had the questionnaire. And somebody asked me a simple question, one of the faculties there. He said that, Swamiji, do we have one line solution to all the problems upon this earth? I said, yes. One line solution to all problems upon this earth. I said, yes. And I said, if all the people upon this earth decided to stop work at 6 p.m. wherever they are and go back to your family, 95% of the problems of your life will be solved. From family time to health to hobby to distressing to relief, everything. Ek hi baat sabko karni hai. To balance sheet of life maintain karna bahut zaruri hai. If you have not enjoyed the growing up of your children, if you not spend hours with your family members sitting in the rain and enjoying good food, what the hell are you doing as a CA? Any professional, doctor or engineer, whatever. I will call my profession as a, because I did my engineering before I took Diksha, way back in 1992. Koi bhi profession mein aap ho, if you have not enjoyed your life at time, it is not a good balance of life. एक अच्छी किताब आपको सजेस्ट करनी है बैलेंस शीट ऑफ लाइफ मेंटेन के लिए. अगर आपके पास पेन और पेपर है आप लिख लेना. एवरी प्रोफेशनल मस्ट रीड दिस बुक. एंड द टाइटल ऑफ द बुक इज द 5 चैंपियन क्वेश्चंस, रिटन बाय अ वेरी गुड रशियन थिंकर एंड अ कॉर्पोरेट ट्रेनर, रॉन कुर्तुस. फर्स्ट नेम इज रॉन, RON, लास्ट नेम इज कुर्तुस, KURTUS. He is a thinker and a corporate trainer. He says that to balance your life well, you need to ask these 5 questions to yourself before you retire for the day. And the first question is, to what am I grateful to today? Aapka din aaj pura hua, to usme kahin logo ka hissa hai? Hai nahi. Your driver made you reach on time even after you got late at home for your first meeting of the day. That means he is a part of your success story. Did you recognize it? Did you with a sense of gratitude appreciate it? Nahi, driver ki to naukri hai, karna hai usko, mujhe le hi jana hai. Lekin aaj bhai sahab aap late the, usne pahuncha diya aapko first meeting ke mein. Aap usko, aapne bola tha ki mujhe 10:15 ko first meeting hai, to aapne aapko pahuncha diya. आपने कभी उसको थैंक यू बोला? दिस इज स्पिरिचुअलिटी. आपके लॉन्ड्री वाला आपको अच्छा ड्रेस बना के देते हैं, ही इज अ पार्ट ऑफ योर सक्सेस स्टोरी. वी हैव नॉट गिवन अ थॉट, क्योंकि रात दिन एक ही विचार चलते हैं, मोर क्लाइंट्स, मोर क्लाइंट्स, मोर मनी. इसलिए ये सब अच्छी अच्छी छोटी छोटी बातें जो जीवन में आनंद देती है, द सेंस ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड. Ask the first question to yourself, to whom am I grateful to today? Second question, where did I do a good job today? Third question, where was I helpful to somebody or some cause today? Fourth question,
How did I take care of myself today? And the fifth question, how did I link up with the basic spiritual values of life today? ये पांच क्वेश्चन रोज आपको आप अपने आप को पूछना बिफोर यू रिटायर फॉर द डे. दैट विल मेक अ गुड बैलेंस शीट ऑफ योर लाइफ. इसमें सेंस ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड आती है, सेंस ऑफ एक्सीलेंस आती है, सेंस ऑफ हेल्प आती है, सेंस ऑफ केयर आती है, सेंस ऑफ लर्निंग आती है. दिस आर ऑल गुड वैल्यूज इन लाइफ. If you want to make yourself great, Swami Vivekananda ye baat karte the. If you want to make yourself strong and great, if you want to make this society strong and great, if you want to make the whole nation strong and great, you need these three things in life. First, conviction in the powers of goodness. Second, absence of jealousy and suspicion. Profession mein ye kabhi mat rakhna hai. Suspicion and jealousy. Aur teesri baat, doing good and trying to do good. Helping all those who are doing good and trying to be good. ये भावना से आप रहेंगे तो जीवन में आनंद रहेगा, जीवन में संतोष रहेगा, स्ट्रेस कभी नहीं आएगा. आप चाहे तो स्ट्रेस को तो यूं भगा सकते हो, आप चाहे तो स्ट्रेस आने ही दे देते. बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग हमारी क्लियर नहीं है, इसलिए स्ट्रेस आ जाता है. यार उसने मेरे साथ प्रैक्टिस चालू की थी, वो इतना बढ़ गया, वो बढ़ा, उसने पुरुषार्थ किया, कुछ दो हेल्प मिल गई, कुछ उसकी डेस्टिनी थी, कुछ सपोर्ट मिल गया. तू अपना प्रयत्न कर. हा या ना? डोंट गिव टाइम इन पीपिंग इन टू समबडीज विंडो. जस्ट गिव टाइम टू योर सेल्फ. मेक योर सेल्फ ग्रो बोथ एज अ प्रोफेशनल एज अ ह्यूमन बींग. प्रोफेशनल अच्छी तरह से ग्रो होना है, टू ग्रो एज अ ह्यूमन बींग भूल जाते हैं. So, अगर वो भूल गए तो मैन इज बॉर्न क्राइंग, ही लिव्स कंप्लेनिंग एंड ही डाइज अनसेटिस्फाइड. रोते रोते पैदा होता है, फरियाद करते करते जीता है और पूर्ण असंतोष के साथ मरता है. यार वो नहीं हुआ, ये नहीं हुआ, वो करना था, ये रह गया. एक ऑफिस मुंबई के साथ पुणे में भी सेटअप करनी थी, वो नहीं चल रहा है, जम नहीं रहा है, मर जाएगा तू. एक मुंबई मुंबई की ठीक है. So basic values in life. Another good aspect of balance in life. मैं कई बार एक बात सिखाता हूं जो equation मैंने design किया है, वो है the equation of 40-30-20-10. ये equation साथ लेके जाना. Everything in life is 40-30-20-10. ये सब मिला के 100 हो गया. 40-30-20-10. वो क्या है? ध्यान से सुनना. आपके जीवन में बैलेंस शीट के लिए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इंग्रेडिएंट एंड एलिमेंट ऑफ द ऑल वर्क दैट यू डिसाइड इन योर लाइफ एंड ऑफ ऑल द रिलेशंस दैट यू स्टार्ट इन योर लाइफ. दो ही मुख्य है जीवन में, रिलेशंस और वर्क. ऑफ ऑल द वर्क एंड रिलेशंस दैट यू स्टार्ट एंड डिसाइड इन योर लाइफ, 40% ऑफ वर्क एंड रिलेशंस विल गो योर वे, योर डिसाइडेड वे, ब्रिंग सक्सेस टू यू. 30% of all the work and relationships that you have decided and started, you will have to put in a lot of energy and put in, pump in a lot of resources to just make it move and bring at par level. That comes down to 70. 40 plus 30 is 70. Another 20% of the work and relations that you have started and decided, it will fail. Accept it. Taki aap tension mein na jaye. Balance sheet maintain rahe. 20% of all the work that you have decided and 20% of all the relations that you have decided are going to fail. This is the equation for 7 billion upon this earth. To uske liye chintit mat hona. Acceptance is a big value in life. Nahi, mere table pe se, meri office mein se, 20 saal ka chartered accountancy ka anubhav hai, sabhi kaam hone chahiye. You are wrong. Because if there are 10 factors affecting the outcome of the project in terms of success, there are 20 factors which are not in your control which will affect the outcome of the success negatively. Yes or no? And the last 10% of the work and relationships that you have started and want, relations would become enmity or severe competition, and work would miserably fail to bring a heavy loss in your life. ये भी स्वीकार लेना. ये जब बने relations हो, तीन try देना 6 महीने तक, every second month, and then if the relations does not build up, wish that person good, pray for him, turn around your face, you be happy, I also be happy, and most importantly, don't forget to delete his number from the mobile. ताकि यहां ठीक रहे, जब भी स्क्रॉल करेंगे वो व्यक्ति का नाम आएगा, इसने मुझे दगा दिया, मैंने तो सही भावना रखी थी. वो दगा देने के लिए आया था, कुछ कर्म के संबंध होते हैं. 40-30-20-10 इज द प्रिंसिपल. नाउ चेक योर लाइफ, आई विल बी राइट. आगे भी देखते रहना जीवन में. 40-30-20-10. तो देर आर अदर फैक्टर्स इफेक्टिंग द आउटकम. ये मत सोचना ऑलवेज माई इंटेलिजेंस विल वर्क, always my planning will work, always my execution is will work, because you know I am a chartered accountant since 30 years. bahut anubhav hai mujhe, mera planning, mera execution kaam hi karna chahiye. nahi hota aisa, aaya na, nahi hoga. batau main aapko practical proof se batau, aap mujhe ha kahenge. aap sabko anubhav hoga ki kahin baar अच्छा प्लानिंग किया, अच्छा एग्जीक्यूशन किया, फिर भी प्रोजेक्ट में इच्छा थी इतना सक्सेस नहीं मिला, या कम मिला, या फेल भी हुआ. यस और नो? और अदर एंड ऑफ द स्टोरी, यू ऑल मच हैव एक्सपीरियंस समटाइम्स विद लेसर प्लानिंग, लेसर एग्जीक्यूशन, और समटाइम्स पुअर एग्जीक्यूशन, समटाइम्स यू गॉट रिजल्ट्स बियॉन्ड योर एक्सपेक्टेशन. यस और नो? व्हाट डज दैट मीन? That means beyond your intelligence, beyond your experience, beyond your planning and beyond your execution, there are other factors who decide the final outcome. Yes or no? वो आपके कर्म है, destiny and God's blessings. God अगर चाहते हैं कि आप कोई भी planning करो, ये project में आपको success नहीं देना है. Never to work seriously for 8 hours a day. Put all your resources behind all the projects that you have on hand. But with the understanding, after all my resources put behind it, final outcome, I will accept it with grace. तो balance sheet अच्छी maintain रहेगी life की, वरना tension में आ जाओगे. यही बात भगवान श्री कृष्ण ने गीता में कही है, कर्मण्येवाधिकारस्ते मा फलेषु कदाचन. Lord Krishna has told Arjun that you perform your duty well, results I will decide. कोई बड़े अच्छे प्रोजेक्ट में अच्छा प्लानिंग किया तो भी मैं आपको फेलियर दूंगा, कृष्ण कहने की बात यह है. और कोई छोटा प्रोजेक्ट या बड़ा प्रोजेक्ट हो, आपने ठीक प्लानिंग भी नहीं किया, एग्जीक्यूशन भी नहीं किया, तो भी बड़ा सक्सेस आपको देना है, वो मैंने तैयार किया है. और वो तैयार करते हैं ऐसे जगलिंग में नहीं, हाँ, लॉटरी सिस्टम नहीं है वहां पर. आपके पास्ट कर्मज आपकी डेस्टिनी के मुताबिक होता है. देन वाई आर यू गेटिंग डिस्टर्ब? Pramukh Swami Maharaj, who was the spiritual head of this organization 65 years as president, and as I said, we are one of the largest top 10 NGOs of the world. Unko ek bar Natu Bhai Patel Elecon Engineering Company ke general manager the, unko pucha ke Swami ji, maine aapko har kriya mein, pure din mein, dincharya mein dekha hai, meeting people, sitting in an administrative meeting, planning, execution, lekin kabhi aapke chehre pe maine tanav nahi dekha, कभी आपके चेहरे पे कोई टायर्डनेस टेंशन नहीं देखा, क्यों? एंड प्रमुख स्वामी महाराज रिप्लाइड, फाइन, आई गेव यू द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ हिज वर्क. मैंने अभी 15-20 मिनट पहले उनका जी दिनचर्या और वर्क था, मैंने आपको कैलकुलेशन दिया था. ही इज इन द गिनीज बुक ऑफ वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड 6 times. ही वॉज फेलिसिटेटेड 40 की टू द सिटीज इन अमेरिका, एंड फेलिसिटेटेड विद अ स्टैंडिंग ओवेशन इन द ब्रिटिश पार्लियामेंट, कैनेडियन पार्लियामेंट, केनियन पार्लियामेंट. उनको पूछा कि आप इतना 8-10 घंटा काम करते हो, कभी आपके चेहरे पे टेंशन नहीं देखा, स्ट्रेस नहीं देखा, क्यों? प्रमुख स्वामी रिप्लाइड, इन द मॉर्निंग व्हेन आई वेक अप, आई प्रे टू गॉड एंड से व्हाट वर्क आई एम सपोज टू डू टुडे. आई प्लान आउट माय वर्क, पुट ऑल माय रिसोर्सेज फॉर द सक्सेस टू ब्रिंग ऑप्टिमम रिजल्ट्स इन द प्रोजेक्ट्स, बट इन द इवनिंग एट 6 आई गिव ऑल दैट वर्क बैक टू गॉड दैट आई ट्राइड माय बेस्ट. Whatever results you decide, I will accept it. This is balance sheet of life. Tension कहाँ आता है और balance sheet कहाँ बिगड़ जाती है? Anyhow I want this result.
एनी हाउ आपका नहीं चलेगा. अटैच टू योर वर्क, रिमेन अटैच टू योर एफर्ट, बट रिमेन डिटैच विद द रिजल्ट. ये मैजिक है भारतीय शास्त्रों का, महान संतों का. और आज ये मैजिक पश्चिम के जगत में उन्होंने अपनी रिसर्च करके, सो ऑल क्रेडिट्स टू देम, उन्होंने अपनी रिसर्च करके बताया. आज टॉप क्लास जो मैनेजमेंट गुरुज हैं, जिम कॉलिंस, स्टीफन कोवी, ऑग मैंडिनो, कैन ब्लैंचार, एंथनी रॉबिन्स, स्टीव शिव खेरा, ये सब फॉर्च्यून 500 कंपनीज के एग्जीक्यूटिव को एक वर्ड सिखाते हैं, बहुत अच्छा वर्ड है, डिटैच्ड अटैचमेंट. दिस इज बैलेंस शीट ऑफ लाइफ. From morning 9 to evening 6, fully attach yourself with your work. Evening 6, detach from it. Forget yourself as a professional. You are a wonderful human being. Because as Warren Buffett says, don't feel that we are human beings on a short spiritual journey. No, we are actually spiritual beings on a very short human journey. 70-80 साल का ये खेल है, बिगाड़ मत देना. 70-80 साल का खेल है, बिगाड़ मत देना. तो दैट इज बैलेंस ऑफ लाइफ. हाउ मेनी मिनट्स आई हैव नाउ? 5 मिनट्स. ओके, सो दिस इज द बैलेंस शीट ऑफ लाइफ दैट यू नीड टू टेक इनटू कंसिडरेशन. और ऐसे महान संत, प्रमुख स्वामी महाराज आज अभी हमारे गुरु है, महान स्वामी महाराज और बड़े बड़े संतों ने अपने जीवन में से बताया है और जीवन में गौर करके बताया है कि जीवन में भगवान में श्रद्धा को भी प्राधान्य देना, भगवान की भक्ति, भगवान में श्रद्धा, भगवान को प्रार्थना और नाम स्मरण को भी प्राधान्य देना. दिस नॉट बिकॉज आई एम अ सेंट दैट आई एम टॉकिंग टू यू. आई एम अ मैन ऑफ साइंस एंड अ मैन ऑफ स्पिरिचुअलिटी बोथ. मोर देन 50,000 पेपर्स हैव बीन पब्लिश्ड इन नेशनल इंटरनेशनल सेमिनार्स. हाउ फेथ इन गॉड कैन मेक यू अ गुड प्रोफेशनल, कैन मेक यू अ गुड ह्यूमन बींग, कैन यू मेक यू अ गुड रिलेटिव और अ फ्रेंड. Not by man of philosophy and man of religion, by man of science. Someday baat karenge, I can prove you the existence of God logically and scientifically. By this research of 50,000 scientists. Mere paas 500 se jyada paper hai. Ek choti si research aapko bataun. How faith in God makes you a complete human being. Aap University of Pennsylvania ki website pe jana. वहां डॉक्टर एंड्रयू न्यूबर्ग और डॉक्टर एच जी कोइंग का एक एक्सपेरिमेंट है, वो आप पढ़ना. आई टॉक यू एब्सोल्यूटली साइंटिफिक. दे गॉट टूगेदर 4,000 पीपल फ्रॉम अक्रॉस नॉर्थ अमेरिका ऑफ ऑल एज ग्रुप्स, अक्रॉस कास्ट, क्रीड, रिलीजन, नेशनलिटी, और एक एक्सपेरिमेंट किया. बिफोर द स्टार्ट ऑफ दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट, ऑल दिस 4,000 पीपल्स माइंड्स वेयर done MRI and mind mapping by special psycho neuro softwares, ताकि उनके pituitary gland क्या hormones secrete करते हैं जब वो tension में आते हैं, अच्छी अच्छी बात करते हैं या हंसते हैं या भगवान का नाम स्मरण करते हैं. Changes in the secretion of hormones of different glands, ये psycho neuro softwares पकड़ सकते हैं. It was a scientific experiment. So it was done, their files prepared, and then they were asked to sit on the floor in the Indian sitting posture, in the meditation posture. Close your eyes and chant the holy name of God for 12 minutes. 3-4 baar ye experiment karwaya. Phir bole ki aap ghar jao. 8 week tak ye kar raha. 8 week ke baad aap wapas aana. They came back after 8 weeks and they were again made to sit in the Indian sitting posture. 12 minutes of chanting the holy name, 2-3 times done. Again by psycho neuro softwares, their mind mapping and MRIs were done. And the conclusion report you can see on this website. The conclusion report reads that those in the age group of 4 to 12, by this chanting the holy name, they had 15-19% increase in their memory power. Isn't this a big advantage for the children of that age, 4 to 12? The second age group was 12 to 22. The psycho neuro softwares, they suggested that these teenagers and youngsters, they had 9-15% increase in their willpower and confidence because of chanting the holy name. Third age group was 22-60, most of us that we are sitting here today. They had the advantage of 15-23% increase in their buffer capacity, that is capacity to absorb shocks of life. क्योंकि जो भी झटके आते इसी उम्र में आते हैं, 22 से 60 में,
पर्सनल लाइफ, फैमिली लाइफ, प्रोफेशनल लाइफ में
9 to 15% इंक्रीज इन योर बफर कैपेसिटी. एंड द लास्ट एज ग्रुप वॉज 60 to 80, द ओल्ड एज पीपल, रिटायर्ड पीपल, दे हैड एन अनबिलीवेबल 15 to 23% इंक्रीज इन दियर स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ इम्यून सिस्टम, रोग प्रतिकारक शक्ति में. At the age of 80, you get a 20% increase in immune system strength. It's a big achievement of life.
So this University of Pennsylvania, Dr. H.G. Coing and Dr. Andrew Newberg, they proved by practical survey, an absolute scientific experiment, that chanting the holy name of God for 12 minutes can give you increase in memory power, can give you increase in willpower, confidence, buffer capacity, and strength of immune system. Doesn't this 5 values make you a better human being? Yes or no? This 5 values gained by an increase of 15% in life, doesn't it help you make you a good human being, a better one?
ये तो मैंने आपको एक एक्सपेरिमेंट की बात की. मेरे पास ऐसे 500 एक्सपेरिमेंट के प्रूफ्स विद नेम्स ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूट्स एंड साइंटिस्ट मेरे पास है. तो कभी नास्तिकवाद मन में मत रखना कि भगवान को देखा नहीं है, कहां होंगे. ये सब एक्सपेरिमेंट से प्रूव होता है कि ये लाभ है. तो बैलेंस ऑफ लाइफ के लिए भगवान में श्रद्धा रखना, बैलेंस ऑफ लाइफ के लिए उनके साथ कनेक्शन में रहना. आई एंड विद द लास्ट थिंग. द मोस्ट कोवेटेड एंड डेकोरेटेड मैनेजमेंट गुरु अपॉन दिस अर्थ, स्टीफन कोवी, उनकी पुस्तक है 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. जिन्होंने नहीं पढ़ी हो जरूर पढ़ना, एज अ प्रोफेशनल यू मस्ट रीड. ही मेट मोर देन 3,000 प्रोफेशनल्स, सक्सेसफुल पीपल. नॉट जस्ट सक्सेसफुल एज अ प्रोफेशनल, सक्सेसफुल एज अ हस्बैंड और अ वाइफ, एज अ ब्रदर, एज अ सिस्टर, एज अ नेबर, एज अ रिलेटिव, मतलब सक्सेसफुल इन ऑल वॉक्स ऑफ लाइफ. ऐसे 3,000 लोगों के इंटरव्यू स्टीफन कोवी ने लिए, उसके बाद यह पुस्तक लिखा है 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. उन्होंने लिखा कि इन 3,000 लोगों में मैंने ये 7 habits कॉमन देखी, जिसकी वजह से वे जीवन में हर तरह से सक्सेसफुल हुए. आप शांति से पुस्तक पढ़ना. फर्स्ट हैबिट वॉज प्रोएक्टिव, प्रतिकूल परिस्थिति में सानुकूल प्रतिभाव, विच विल मेंटेन योर गुड बैलेंस ऑफ लाइफ. सेकेंड वॉज बिगिन विद द एंड इन माइंड. थर्ड वॉज पुटिंग फर्स्ट थिंग्स फर्स्ट. फोर्थ हैबिट वॉज थिंक विन विन, आप भी जीते मैं भी जीतूं, आप भी कमाओ मैं भी कमाऊं, आप भी प्रगति करें मैं भी प्रगति करूं, जो हमारे गुरु प्रमुख साईं महाराज का स्लोगन था, इन द जॉय ऑफ अदर्स लाइज़ अवर ओन. फिफ्थ हैबिट थी सीक फर्स्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड देन टू बी अंडरस्टूड. सिक्स्थ हैबिट थी सिनर्जी, दो या दो से ज्यादा लोग साथ में आए काम करें, कॉमन मिनिमम प्रोग्राम पे आए. हाँ, डिफरेंस ऑफ ओपिनियन तो रहते हैं साथ में आते हैं तो, लेकिन कॉमन मिनिमम प्रोग्राम में CMP में आ जाए और काम करे, प्रोजेक्ट पूरा करे और दूसरे प्रोजेक्ट साथ करने का आनंद ले, दैट इज कॉल्ड सिनर्जी. और आखिरी हैबिट थी शार्पन द सॉ, फिजिकल, मेंटल, इमोशनल हेल्थ. उसमें स्टीफन कोवी ने बताया कि ये 3,000 सक्सेसफुल लोगों को मैं मिला, उन सब के जीवन में ये एक आदत थी, हैबिट थी. नाउ आई एम कोटिंग हिम वर्ड टू वर्ड, नो लेटर टू लेटर. ही राइट्स इन दिस बुक दैट दे हैड द हैबिट ऑफ कनेक्टिंग विद देयर क्रिएटर every day through prayers. वो रोज अपने सर्जनहार के साथ कनेक्शन रखते थे प्रेयर्स के माध्यम से. तो ये बात है, ये बात हकीकत है. ये टॉप मैनेजमेंट गुरुज आपको ये सिखाते हैं. जिम कॉलिंस को अगर आपको बुलाना है नेक्स्ट टाइम कॉन्फ्रेंस में, इज द हाईएस्ट पेड मैनेजमेंट गुरु अपॉन दिस अर्थ. एनी चार्जेस नॉट मोर, जस्ट $1,00,000 फॉर 1 hour ऑफ टॉकिंग. आपको अगर आपकी CA कॉन्फ्रेंस में बुलाना तो ये उनके रेट्स हैं, $100,000 फॉर 1 hour ऑफ टॉकिंग. चलो आप राउंड फिगर ले लो, अभी तो भाव होंगे 66, 67, व्हाटएवर, लेट्स टेक 60 लाख रुपीज फॉर 1 hour ऑफ टॉकिंग, दैट इज 1 lakh रुपीज फॉर 1 minute ऑफ टॉकिंग. एक सेकंड के कितने हुए CS बैठे, 1 minute के 1 lakh रुपीज, तो एक सेकंड के कितने हुए, करीबन 1700-1800 गिन लो. For 1 second of talking, what must he be talking? वो आपको भगवान में श्रद्धा, क्योंकि उनके सामने जो बैठे हैं वो स्टूडेंट्स नहीं हैं, प्रोफेशनल्स हैं, फॉर्च्यून 500 के एग्जीक्यूटिव हैं, जो लोग 10,000 crore, 15,000 crore का टर्नओवर ऐसे ही संभालते हैं. 1500 लोगों को उनके हाथ के नीचे काम करते हैं। उन लोगों को मैनेजमेंट नहीं सिखाना है, वो लोग अपने आप में माहिर है। उन लोगों को एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन नहीं सिखाना है, तो जिम कॉलिंस उनको सिखाते क्या होंगे कि 8 महीने तक उनकी अपॉइंटमेंट नहीं मिलती आपको, और वो जब स्टेज पे आते हैं एग्जीक्यूटिव्स ऑफ दिस क्लास दे आर इन ड्रॉप जॉब पोजीशन, उनके सामने बैठ जाते हैं तो बोलते क्या होंगे जो आपने पिछले 1 घंटे से मुफ्त में सुना। यही बोलते हैं। प्रोफेशनल्स को बैलेंस ऑफ लाइफ सिखाते हैं, क्योंकि और कुछ तो उन लोगों को सिखाना है नहीं, वो लोग हाई एंड प्रोफेशनल्स हैं, फॉर्च्यून 500 एग्जीक्यूटिव्स हैं, लेकिन वो 3-पीस सूट में होते हैं, टाई पहनी होती हैं, कॉलर माइक होते हैं, और स्टेज पे चलते चलते बोलते हैं, उसके चार्ज है। और हम भगवे कपड़े में बोलते हैं, लगा ये संत को बोलने की तो ठीक है आदत है, बोलते रहते हैं। कहने की बात ये है, बैलेंस ऑफ लाइफ प्रोफेशनल्स को सिखाते हैं। सो द बैलेंस शीट ऑफ लाइफ इज दिस।